boom. Took a second to load up there. I was like, posed and ready. What's up, everybody? RageCage20 here, coming with something new for the channel and pretty new for myself as well. I don't know how. I was watching something. Don't remember what. Something. I want to say either like ICP, maybe Ouija Mac related, something like that. I think I saw a video of like, it was like a drawing of like three or four rappers that were rapping together and whatnot. And one of them looked female and whatnot. I was like, oh, okay, let me check this out. And I didn't watch that video, but I went to find out, you know, I was like, okay, which one of them is the female rapper? And I found Whitney here. Whitney Payton. That's who we're listening to today. And I listened to one of her songs, Give It Gas. And I was like, you know what? It's pretty good. It's pretty good. I feel like she deserves a chance on the video. The thumbnail of this video, Villain, it's the one we're listening to today, looked very interesting. Looked like she was wearing some kind of some outfit, like it was like a bunny rabbit or a rat or something mixed with Mad Max. Very, very interesting. So I'm interested to see what Whitney can bring to the table, as I said in a different video. I don't remember which one, but as I said in a different video when I was thinking of checking out Whitney, anyone who can rhyme fallopian tubes, you have my attention. You know what I mean? If you could fit fallopian tubes into your rhyme and make it sound actually pretty badass, like a pretty badass flex, like you have my attention. And what I really liked is that in that video there was nothing that was like sexual. She didn't go into like super sexuality or anything. There was barely even a yo bitch line in there. She did kind of sneak one of those in there, but it was like barely. So I was just like, you know what? Respect. I'm down. So here we are. Let's check it out. Whitney Payton, Villain, official video. Let's see what you step up to the plate. Whitney, let's see what you got. Let's see what you can bring.
The villain is me. Pessimistically, I'm narcissistic. Meaning link is in my bio and you all can click it. I only know I'm gifted based on the likes that I get. The dopamine inside my system, it don't know the difference between the clout and love. I'm never down when you're swiping up. And when it's dark, sing a face to lighten up. I think I'll never get the hang of this shit if I'm suppressing misery through all the bragging and shit. Wait, this is what I wanted, this is what I wanted. Sitting in a meeting, getting judged upon my numbers, yeah. It's ironic all the numbers we be crunching when really very few of us is keeping it 100, yeah. I remember I was crying asleep. I hid a girlfriend for 6 years and finding my peace. I guess I hate the word dyke if it's flying at me. So I avoided any questions that would rile the sheep. And that was toxic, tripping on my conscience. Heavily weighted, I was taking over with nonsense. Living with these monsters inside me, it was constant. Rather be honest than be admired and accomplished. I'd rather be dead, cast out, rejected instead than feeding into all the demons as they dance in my head. And no one tells you when your dreams take off. Certain feelings you just can't shake off.
It's been so hard to love and trust. I built these bridges just to burn them up. I looked in the mirror and what did I see? Turns out the villain is me.
Yeah, yeah, well.
Life goes on, yeah. Life goes on.
Repeated, then expecting all these different things to happen. Entrapment until your mind is smothered in a loop. And oftentimes it's disguised as comfort. In the booth talking rhymes like I wanna cover all the truth and suffering inside the good production. Good for nothing. I told my dad I graduated.
graduated, but I never did. I'm getting sick of people asking if I'm having kids. I need to handle shit, it's really not your business. So you're an open book, well damn, I'm a locked Kindle. And no, it's not simple now to really open up, even if you're showing love for me when things are going rough. How do I know that you won't switch up? So I'ma cut you out the damn picture.
It's been so hard to love and trust. I built these bridges just to burn them up. I looked in the mirror and what did I see? Turns out the villain is me.
Yeah, yeah, well.
Life goes on, yeah. Life goes on.
First off, that tattoo is badass. The one in the mouth, the beast like wolf like, yeah, with a hand. That's fucking sick as fuck. Ooh. Okay. So, I kind of assumed so at the last song that after when you know I mentioned the yo bitch line, as you said that it was like yo, I'm gonna straight up steal your wife or something like that, and I'll date her. I assumed that she was into women and whatnot, but it's good to have it confirmed in the song, which is very interesting because like I don't know, looking at her like. I don't know. I mean, I assume people would probably just call her a dyke, just to piss her off. Really, if you're just trying to insult her or something like that, and whatnot, like it's an easy swing. But like, there's never a moment. I mean, it's only been two or three images that I've ever seen her in so far, including this one. But never once have I looked at her and thought like, oh man, she looks like a dykey lesbian or something. Like that's never crossed my mind. So. I don't know if she gets that a lot, but I assume it's only just because, oh, that's something they can say because she's not, you know, I don't know, because she had short hair in that one, but the other picture she has long hair, like, yeah, never have I looked at it, I thought, like, oh, she kind of looks like a dude, yeah, she's a dyke, you know, like, I've never once ever thought that, so, I don't know, I guess, I don't know, maybe makes you feel, helps you feel better or something, you know, that not everyone thinks that. And probably only a few people think that that's only because they just want to hurt you or something. I don't know. Who knows? That was really good. Yeah. Like. Like, how do I put this? There's a lot of things that I'm not a fan of when it comes to. Well, not a lot of things. There's a handful of things that I'm not a huge fan of when it comes to rap. Just no matter who is rapping, or R&B, hip-hop, whatever the genre is, no matter who's spitting the bars, no matter what gender you are, I'm not a huge fan of, my money, I'm smoking all this weed, and just sexual shit in general. Oh, I fuck bitches. I got a huge dick, you know. That's not really stuff that I'm just like, yeah, these bars though. You know, I mean, that's kind of like the stereotypes you get of like a lot of rap music. It's just it's all about getting money, fucking bitches, smoking weed. Like that's all everyone sings about in rap and whatnot. That's a stereotype, obviously that's not true, but you know, that's the imagery and whatnot. That's like kind of the stuff that like I'm not really a fan of. And the other video there, it seems like obviously there's a lot of guys that you know, that, like a yo bitch line is like in every single rap song, especially written by men ever. So like, I don't know. Obviously, I'm not saying that you know, male rappers are perfect, but usually when it comes to female rappers, and I even was having this conversation with another woman who's like, yeah, I don't like listening to female rap because pretty much all of them are just talk about their sexuality and their pussy and stuff like that. Like, that's all they talk about and whatnot. And in that little, I mean, could not be, you know, I'm just purely judging on the fact that how much clothing she is not wearing. So, Melissa, I am sorry if this is completely incorrect, but that bad B, which I'm sure is bad bitch, there's, you know, asterisks right there, visualizer there with Whitney and Melissa Marie, who, just looking at Melissa with very little, no clothing and whatnot, I assume that's what she would rap about, is like her sexuality and stuff like that. To where it's just like male, female, anywhere in between. I don't want to hear it. that's not the kind of content I want to hear about and whatnot. Why that's related and why that's important here is that two for two Whitney Payton songs, she has not talked about her vaginal region, or besides fallopian tubes, obviously, but like no one talks about fallopian tubes in a sexual way. Vaginal region or sex or her sexuality at all. She's just sticking to the straight up, yo, this is who I am, this is what's going on inside of me and stuff, and this is a part of fame and stuff that you don't think about. Y'all think you want it, but like, here's the reality, what it's going to do to you mentally and stuff. She's just sticking to that. And you know what? I respect the absolute motherfucking hell out of that. Like, Whitney, that's what's up. Like, that is 100% a buck there. That is what's up. And I appreciate that. Especially the first verse. I'm going to have to really look into the second verse, but especially that first verse. She was spitting fucking bars in there. There is some good rhyme schemes going on there. There was some good just bars and just hard hitting topics in there as well. Like, and her fucking hook, man. Her hook, she's singing on the hook. She wasn't singing in the last song, but she puts in this beautiful singing hook in there. Okay, you know what? You know, Whitney, you have definitely got my attention. You got me hooked in here, and I want to hear more. I don't got a whole lot of time, so we need to get a hippity hoppity skippity jump into here, because I don't mean to keep bringing this up. I ain't trying to flex or anything. It's just, you know, I'm a busy man. I'm working two jobs. One, very physically demanding and whatnot, so like, I need regular deep tissue and cupping massages like every 2 weeks to make sure my body doesn't break down, because I am standing up on my legs, working my ass off 8 hours a day every single motherfucking day. Usually on concrete, one of the jobs. So I'm taking lots of precautions. Like, I have more I have literally found a way to compress my entire body. I do have a wrist compression sleeve that you may have seen me wear before in these videos, because that's actually because I injured my wrist many, many years ago, and that actually helps when playing video games and whatnot. When I go to work, I have compression socks go all the way from my feet all the way up to my knees. I have knee compression braces on. I even have lower back compression. I don't wear it anymore because I don't need it, because I found a way to stand up straight, so the back pain stopped. But that plus I need regular massages to keep this body going so I can work two jobs. So I'm not saying this as a flex. I got a massage to get to here in like 25-30 minutes, so we need to get this bitch going. I was a fan of what I saw. I was hearing a few bars, but I wasn't really paying attention to a lot of it. I was just kind of listening as an experience visually and kind of just letting the audio pass over and whatnot. But now we need to deep dive in this. Let's start from the beginning with this beautiful singing hook intro.
It's been so hard to
right, and what heightened it in the intro that was just like, okay, we're getting somewhere out the gate here, is that fucking like almost movie like bass in there. Dum, 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 dum. Like, yes, please. Yes, please, and thank you.
It's been so hard to love and just die.
I like that line. Dun 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 dun. Nice little like half steps dissonance in there. Dun 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 dun. Like that is a beautiful melodic line just in general. And yeah, I wouldn't expect that in a rap song. Like, let's go, Whitney. I've been listening to that song again recently. I just noticed it popped up there for a second.
Anyways. I looked in the mirror, and what did I see? Turns out the villain is me.
That's right, I remember that. First off, everything breaks out. That kind of dissonant, echoey voice has been going on through here. Dun 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 dun. Dun 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 dun, with that very deep, lumberly, low-end core piano sound. Okay, that's one hell of an intro, Whitney. That was one hell of a motherfucking intro there. Oh, let's get that break in here again.
I looked in the mirror, and what did I see? Turns out the villain is me.
Pessimistically, I'm narcissistic, meaning link is in my bio and you all can click it.
We're probably going to be pausing a lot here to check out these bars, because there's a lot of them and they're pretty good here. Pessimistic, narcissistic, that kind of inner rhyme there. Pessimistically, I'm narcissistic, meaning, again, I'm a narcissist, you know, someone who loves themselves, very, you know, in love with themselves and what have you. Meaning, link is in my bio. Y'all can click it. You can all click my link. Come look at me. Give me some money. You know what I mean? Like, that right out the gate with that inner rhyme going into that inner rhyme into explanation of what that means. With a flex on it. Okay, that is fuck. Okay.
Turns out the villain is me.
Pessimistically, I'm narcissistic. Meaning, link is in my bio and you all can click it. I only know I'm gifted based on the likes that I get. The dopamine inside my system, it don't know the difference between the clout and love. I'm never down when you're swiping up.
So, let's take a look at that. First off, I like that. She's got like. Like fading out of existence. Interesting. I'll only know I'm gifted based on the likes that I get, you know. That is kind of like a downfall of the music industry at the current moment, and just like YouTube and social media in general, is that like I only know if I'm good. Like, you know, don't believe it yourself. I only know if I'm good if you people leave a like on all my social media and stuff and tell me that I'm good and whatnot, which, you know, creates that dopamine rush inside the head, that feel good chemical going off there. The dopamine in my system, it don't know the difference. It doesn't know the difference between whether it's real or not. It doesn't care. I see that like whether it means anything or not, since that dopamine going through my system, like, ooh, it doesn't know the difference between clout and love. If you guys actually love me, or if it's just for the clout or whatnot. God damn. That's a hell of an opening bar there. And I love the down and up here. I'm never down when you're swiping up. Like, that's a good twist. There's some good twists on these bars here. A good twist. A good flip. I like it. Let's go back a little bit. Let's keep going here. Whoop.
My system, it don't know the difference between the clout and love. I'm never down when you're swiping up, and when it's dark, sing a face to lighten up. I think I'll never get the hang of this shit if I'm suppressing misery through all the bragging and shit. Wait, this is what I wanted, this is what I wanted. Sitting in a meeting, getting judged upon my numbers. Yeah, it's ironic all the numbers we be crunching when really very few of us is keeping it 100.
I wanted to keep going because I was liking what I hear. First off, beat's nice and simple, just kind of like that, dun, 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 you know, kind of line that's going over the top of it. Very nice, has a nice prettiness to it with the drum and bass kind of sound. Her flow in general is good. I like the tone of the voice. It's all flowing smoothly and whatnot. I like that, all that checking off here. I don't understand the first bar, and when it's dark, sing a face tune, lighten up. I don't get that line. But if I'm suppressing misery through all the bragging and shit, I think I'll never get the hang of this if I'm suppressing misery through all the bragging. It's one of those, you know, you're coming out saying like, hey, look, I'm so awesome. Like, look at the, you know, look at this money. Look at what I'm doing. Like, I'm good at this shit. But the whole time you're just covering up for the constant misery that comes with maybe the anxiety of being good or wondering if people actually like you or, you know, whatnot. Just like covering up all this misery by just talking a big game and whatnot. That's a real bar right there. It was like, but wait, this is what I wanted. I wanted to get this, yet it makes me feel miserable. I'm in these meetings and people are judging me on if I'm good or not, just purely based off the numbers, because that's all that matters in the music industry. Is like, you're good is judged by the money you're bringing in and the eyes that you're attracting and whatnot. And it's ironic that we're here crunching numbers when there's none of us here are actually keeping it full 100, which is, you know, being completely honest or anything like that, I think is what keeping it 100 means. But keep 100% honest or real or anything, you know, because a lot of this is kind of just fake and what have you. Like, that's a lot of bars. It's like there's meanings and bars packed into every one of these lyrics. Every line here, every bar here just has something packed into it, man. I like it. I like it. Let's let it keep going here.
Really bad, few of us is keeping it 100, yeah. I remember I was crying to sleep. I had a girlfriend for 6 years, I'm finding my peace. I guess I hate the word dyke if it's flying at me. So I avoided any questions that would rile the sheep. And that was toxic, tripping on my conscience.
All right, here. So I heard the girlfriend line. I had a girlfriend for 6 years, I'm finding my peace. So I think she was... I mean, like, the unfortunate reality of a lot of people that are homosexual and or have any other sexuality that's out of what's considered the norm and whatnot have to go through to where I guess she was pretending that she was straight or something, or, you know, pretending at least not to be gay and was hiding the fact that she had a girlfriend for many years. And she's trying to find her peace with herself, come to terms with her sexuality and make it okay or whatnot. Bar. I guess I hate the word dyke if it's flying at me. Sure. I feel like there's a flip on that, but I don't know what it is. But anyways. So I avoided any question that would rile the sheep, and that was toxic, tripping on my conscience. So yeah, pretty much hiding who you truly were, and that was toxic to yourself and whatnot. As it's good bars right here, man. It's some deep, real bars right here.
At me, so I avoided any questions that would rile the sheep, and that was toxic, tripping on my conscience. Heavily weighted, I was taken over with nonsense. Living...
I like the switch she did there. Peace, me, sheep. Kind of like those kind of near rhymes and whatnot, and switching it up. You can hear like how she kind of switches up the flow and goes into that different scheme there. And that was toxic, tripping on my conscience, you know, kind of finds a way to fit the to have the cadence of the verse kind of fit that into this new kind of rhyme scheme. Conscience, nonscience, toxic, conscience. Toxic and conscience again is kind of more of a near rhyme, but it kind of like it feels like it rhymes even though it kind of doesn't, especially the way she cadences between the middle and the end of that phrase. Like, nice little good switch up she did there. I like that.
With these monsters inside me, it was constant. Rather be honest than be admired and accomplished. I'd rather be dead, cast out, rejected instead than feeding into all the demons as they dance in my head.
Yeah, no, she's got a very professional flow and rhyme scheme going on here. Like, everything's by the book. Everything's sounding good. Everything's flowing good. I like the little pause she did in there. I don't even want to hear that again. living with these monsters inside me, it was constant. Rather be honest than be admired and accomplished. Which, I mean, that's saying a lot. It's like, I would rather not lie or hide who I really am just to get famous and be admired and whatnot. I'd rather just be honest. I'd rather be dead, cast out, rejected instead. Like, the way she... flowed that, I'd rather be dead, cast out, rejected instead. Like that the way that one went there, and then then feeding into all these demons that dance in my head. Like that rhyme scheme, the way she breaks up that flow. Oh, that was nice. That was clean. That was clean.
And that was toxic, tripping on my conscience. Heavily weighted, I was taking over with nonsense. Living with these monsters inside me, it was constant. Rather be honest than be admired and accomplished. I'd rather be dead, cast out, rejected instead than feeding into all the demons as they dance in my head. Huh. And no one tells you when your dreams take off, certain feelings you just can't shake off. It's been so.
Ugh, like that. And no one tells you when your dreams take off. Certain feelings you just can't shake off. Take, shake, good, you know, it's not just off to off. Take, shake, there's different rhyme there. Take off, shake off, like that. If you're writing, everything is by the book. It flows, it works well. It's good stuff here. That's just a truth bar right there. a lot of people... just kind of off the top of my head, two people I really liked that kind of stopped. Dave is still kind of around. He's not doing really music or anything anymore. but Dave from Boring a Band, Ron from Hi I'm Ron. If you never checked out his Gets Played stuff, he deleted everything he ever did ever. I don't know what happened to him, but I hope he's okay. I don't know if Dodger's still in contact with him or whatnot. He kind of disappeared off the face of the planet and seemed like he had some issues that was going on and whatnot. Dave suffers from extreme anxiety. He's an amazing rapper. But, once he released a song that just blew up and went crazy, he got in his head to where it's just like, I'll never be able to reach this fame again. I'll just be chasing this fame. Nothing I'll do will be as good as this, and people aren't going to like it. People aren't going to like me. He kind of tanked himself emotionally and just started suffering from depression and all this kind of stuff. So it's just like, you know, no one tells you when your dreams come true, when you take off certain stuff, some monsters come into your head and you just can't get rid of them. Truth bars right there. All right. Let's jump forward a little bit here. I do love this hook, but I got stuff to do. Let's go.
Life goes on, yeah. Life goes on. Hoping someday I can right my wrongs. I looked in the mirror and what did I see? Turns out the villain is me.
And we didn't really talk about that in general, but you know, obviously, I mean, people have been using this forever. You know, you look in the mirror, you look at yourself and whatnot, you know, you see your reflection and whatnot, and you find out that, oh, I'm really the villain to myself, not everyone else. You know what I mean? Great bars. Been used before. Very powerful bars. I like those bars. Let's check out this second verse here, because I really did not pay attention to a lot of it, because I was looking at the costume and the imagery and stuff.
It turns out from the people who've been making me hurt, I'm the one who's been allowing it and making it worse. They say that craziness is really just the same routine repeated, then expecting all these different things to happen. Entrapment until your mind is smothered in a loop, and oftentimes it's disguised as comfort. In the booth talking rhymes like I want to cover.
Something's going on here when it's a little disjunct, and I feel like I'm... Interesting. But anyways, yeah, as we were kind of talking out there, for all the people who've been making me hurt, I'm the one who's been allowing it and making it worse. There's a great quote by somebody. I think it was it Roosevelt's wife? Don't remember who. Some first lady, I believe. I don't remember, but I can't remember who it was, but some famous woman had the quote that no one can make you feel bad without your permission, or something like that. I might be paraphrasing, but that was pretty much the gist of it, and they used it on Princess Bride, because, you know, not Princess Bride, Princess Diary, there it is, Anne Hathaway's, you know, yeah. My girl Annie. straight up there, it's like, I'm the one who's been allowing it and making it worse. If you just like, because I have to do that on a daily basis as well, because I get a moderate, slight to moderate amount of hate from comments, because if you're on YouTube and people watch you, you're going to get a lot of hate. No matter how many people like you, how many people dislike you, you're going to get a lot of hate. It happens. I actually just had this, I was replying to messages just yesterday, and there was someone who literally said, "Do you call this a reaction? It was fucking torture. Find a new hobby." And for me, it just made me laugh. It's just like, this is a lot more about you than me. It's just like, I could tell that there's hurt inside of you, and that this is not me. This is not my doing. This is, you know, you're just letting out your hurt anywhere you can find it. So I could have taken that in and let it affect me and allow it and make it worse. But instead, I'm just like, this isn't about me. Like, you're clearly hurting and you're finding an outlet for it. Like, I'll be your villain for you if you want. It's kind of what I said to him. But it's just like, at the end of the day, you know, you're just lashing out from the hate and hurt inside you. I didn't say this, but I was thinking, like, you should get some help. So, yeah. Other people can't make you hurt without your permission. That's some real bars, too. But let's see here. Let me read these here. People have been making me hurt. I'm the one who's allowing it, making it worse. Hurt. Worse. Repeated. Happen. Smothered. Comfort. Cover. So, smothered. Cover. That one. There we go there. Worst hurt happen repeated. Yeah, there's an interesting rhyme scheme going on here. I think it's like intentionally not rhyming and whatnot. Yeah, I don't know. Very interesting. The rhyme scheme, we got very creative with the rhyme scheme here. Let's let it keep going. In a loop, and oftentimes this disguises comfort. In the booth, talking rhymes like I want to cover all the truth is suffering inside the good production. Good for nothing. I told my dad I graduated, but I never did. I'm getting sick of people asking if I'm having kids. I need to handle shit. It's really not your business. So you're an open book. Well, damn, I'm a locked Kindle. So yeah, the rhyme scheme kind of feels a little all over the place, and like we're just abandoning all rules and forms of rhyming and whatnot, which she went out of her way to prove that she's really, really good at that for the first verse. So the second verse, I think this is like absolutely 100% intended. I think that it's kind of like, you want things to be like, you want to hear those rhymes. You know, it's like, I don't care what you want. I got some hurt in me that I need to let out, and I'm just going to spit it and just focus in on the flow rather than the rhyme scheme and whatnot. And, you know, I respect that here, especially with some of these bars here. Good for nothing. I told my dad I graduated, but I never did. First off, I like the good production. Good production. Good for nothing. Like, great little flip there. I like that line. But yeah, I'm getting sick of people asking if I'm having kids. Why do people think, like, if you're ever going to have kids, or if, like, you're literally, if you're pregnant or whatnot, because, like, really, your stomach is flat as board, huh? I don't know what you're talking about. So, I mean, I guess people are just asking, like, oh, hey, you're ever going to have kids and whatnot, which, I mean, my answer to that is, like, nah, probably going to adopt. So, like, I don't really give a fuck if people ask me, but if people kept asking me and whatnot, I'd be like, why the fuck do you care if I'm having kids or not? So I get to see that. But, like, I need to handle shit, and it's really not your business. Oh, you're an open book. Well, I'm a locked Kindle. I like that Kindle book, you know. Yeah, that's a good one. I like that. Good flip there. And no, it's not simple now to really open up, even if you're showing love for me when things are going rough. How do I know that you won't switch up? So I'm going to cut you out the damn picture. That was a little weird in there. So, I mean, if the bar is straight up, you know, hard and going for it, no, it's not simple to open up, even if you're showing love when things are rough, you know, because it's like, you know, you expect, like, are people going to love you when things are going well, but they're going to abandon you when it goes rough. So, like, even I'm at the point where even if you're showing me love when shit's rough, I still don't trust you that you're not going to turn on me at some point. Like, that's bars right there. But how do I know that you won't switch up? So I'm going to cut you out the damn picture. Like, I feel like she like went out of her way to not have any resolution or any kind of rhyme scheme there, especially at the end. I think she did that intentionally. I think she wanted it to be like that. And you know what? I gotta respect that. I gotta respect when you go, when you try to shake up what people want, what people expect, especially in this song, to where it's like, I don't even trust anybody. I'm here battling with myself. I ain't got time to deal with you and what you want. You know what? I respect that.
Been so hard to love and trust. I feel.
And the imagery and everything is, oh, that's an armadillo. Okay. It looks like a bunny. I get it. I wonder if maybe like curl up to protect yourself and block out the outside. Maybe that's imagery there. But yeah, nah, I love the imagery and the desert and all the makeup and everything. Like, looks like some Star Wars stuff here, which is pretty cool. But yeah, very, very interesting imagery here.
These bridges just to burn them up. I looked in the mirror and what did I see? Turns out the villain is me.
Yeah, yeah, well.
Life goes on, yeah. Life goes on.
I like the very simple, again, drum bass beat, but now we got this like pizzicato string stuff going over it. It's just kind of nice and simple with this deep rumbly doom kind of sounds coming in every now and then. It's nice and simple, but it has this nice beauty to it as well.
Hoping someday I can right my wrongs. I looked in the mirror and what did I see?
That would take so long to get out of your hair. I love it. I love that end too. Dun, dun, dun. It's a nice little. You know what? I like that. I dig that. I was feeling that. I like the message. I like the honesty to it. I like the bars that she was flowing with. That first verse, she was killing it and crushing it. The second verse, I thought was more of an artistic choice that maybe didn't make it sound like it flowed as well and as smoothly. But, like, I respect why, at least why I believe that it was done. And I think that was really cool. I love the singing hook in there. Sound really good. Some good musicality to it as well. The beat was sick. You know, I'm digging it. I'm you know, I am digging this. I definitely want to check out more from Whitney. I don't know what that would be. But I definitely want to check out more from her here soon in general. So, very cool. Thank you all for joining me. Let me know if you're big Whitney fans, what other songs I should check out from her. Whitney, thank you for the music. Thank you for the message, even through your hurt and your pain. Appreciate you putting that into music and giving it to all of us. And I will see you all next time.